Good morning, my friends, and welcome back to the Morning Mindset. This is our time to make that powerful choice to set our minds on the things of God. And it's not just a one-time thing, though it does benefit us to make a one-time commitment to this, of setting our minds in the right place. But I'm going beyond that today to help you understand it's a daily decision. It's a daily mindset that we need to set. And we're doing that partly through this morning mindset. Now, before we get into the topic of today's morning mindset, I want you to pause for a moment and think about the benefits you have received thus far in listening to the morning mindset, however long you've been listening. Has it benefited your life? If so, I want to point something out to you. You can help others to benefit in the same way. You can be a catalyst in their lives of helping them get their mind right every day by encouraging them to check out the morning mindset. We have over 6,500 people now who are listening to the morning mindset every day, and you can help that message spread by sharing it with someone else. If you're listening in a podcast player or app, there's a sharing function right there in your app. You may have to swipe right or left or up or down or something like that to find it, but you can share the Morning Mindset episode you're listening to right now via text message, via Facebook Messenger, via email. Somehow you can share that episode. I want to encourage you to think of one person right now who you know would benefit if they would just give it a chance. Share this episode with them right now. Pause it if you need to and come back. And I'm going to be right here. We're going to talk about this thing of setting your mind according to the things of the Spirit. And that's exactly what we introduced a couple of episodes ago. In yesterday's Morning Mindset, we talked about the power of setting your mind on things. And I want to read to you the passage from which I get this idea. This is Romans chapter 8, verse number 6. And listen to the extreme words the Apostle Paul uses in this. He said, "For to set the mind on the flesh," okay, so that's the sinful habits and bents that we all have that's attached to this mortal body. He says, "To set your mind on the flesh is death." Death, that's an extreme word. But he says the opposite as well. "But to set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace." I'm telling you, how many of us need more peace in our lives? You see, we've got to learn this thing that Paul's talking about, how to set our minds on the things of the Spirit, because we all need life and peace. And what's more, the world around us, our spouses, our children, our coworkers, they need to see a life that is lived in true life and in true peace, because they need hope to know that it's possible. And God, through the power of His Spirit and through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, could do that through your life. Do you recognize that? Wherever you are, every single day of your life, whether it's at work or at home or at the store or in some community or civic activities you're involved in, you can be God's demonstration of what it looks like to live a life that is truly life and peace. But it requires that your mind is set on the things of the Spirit. It's that decision we make every single day that I'm going to meditate on the things of the Spirit. I'm going to set my attention on the things of the Spirit. Now, in the next episode, I want to talk a little bit about something we can all relate to, and that is what it is like when our minds are set on things of the flesh. And we all have our different version of it, but I want to talk about it because it illustrates how powerful it is to set your mind on a certain thing and to turn a corner and help us understand what it might be like to set our mind on things of the Spirit in a powerful way, in a way that will transform the way we live and the way we impact those around us. I'm telling you, this is not just a benefit to our lives. It's a transformative thing for those who are around us every single day. Join me again tomorrow for the Morning Mindset.